What's going on? Reporting in. Sick as a dog. I got like a cold or something. Getting something down. Island life, man. I'm late again. Basically, what prevented me from doing a video early this time was because of the holiday. Like, all our stuff were in Ireland, so everything comes in through ferry. So because Monday was a holiday, stuff that was supposed to come Thursday didn't show up till Friday. So one of my comic book stores got their stuff Friday. The other one was told they're going to have to wait until today, just because they didn't get a chance to deliver everything on Friday that was late. So I could have done like a haul video Friday, but I figured I'd wait for all my stuff to come. It's like, oh, my phone, I should probably put it on silent. I apologize. Man, this is gonna be, might be a longer video. My haul was, I got three back issues and like a massive stack of new ones. I got quite a few of the highly talked about DC 3D covers. A lot that I don't even collect. I just like, I like the villains, so, or it's a book I'm interested in jumping on, so I want to find out about the villain, and I just generally thought they were cool. I bought some extra other stuff, so I'll do the other stuff first, and then we'll get on that. Obviously, first up, bought myself a lovely Silver Age Iron Man shirt. Decided it was about time I do, there we go. I do some videos and actually wear some comic shirts. And then had to buy this pretty sweet Marvel one, if you can feel that, yeah. So basically it's just the hands of all the characters and stuff. I thought it was pretty cool. So I picked that up. Then I also picked up, if you remember from some of the early videos, our dollar store started carrying like these little mini figures. They had bigger ones and then littler ones. I had the Hulk for each set. So for the littler ones, I just decided to man up and try to get them all. The only one I don't have is Iron Man. So I got Thor. I got Spider-Man, I got Wolverine, and I got Captain America, so I just need Iron Man. I have the whole set. Kind of makes me upset because on the package they have Venom, but Venom's actually not one of the figures apparently, so it's probably why they're in the dollar store. So basically, I did have them sealed. I usually don't open stuff that comes in packages like that, but they're for the dollar store, so I'm probably going to put them on my windowsill or on my desk or something. I'll do a quick little update that the collection video, I say it every time, and then I say it every time. The collection video is coming very soon. I'm on my third long box, and the end is, I can see the end. I probably only have about 50 more comics to sort through and divide and stuff. So, that's coming along very nicely. So, I'm hoping sometime this week I'll be done and get that shot. Because I do want you guys, I think you guys will connect a little more if you see what my collection's like. And then I got this, this thing that, for the my room here, as you see, you can kind of see the walls are kind of bare, other than James Brown in the back there. So I'm putting up more posters and some art stuff. I got this for $10 at HMV all places. I thought it was kind of cool. So I'm not a big Superman guy. I collect Superman Unchained, but I thought this was a cool drawing of him. It's you can hear that, it's tin. So I thought that was kind of cool, and it's actually pretty large. So there's that. So now we will get to the, I disappeared there for a sec. I'm trying to make room here. We'll get to the issues. Half of them I read, because like I said, I got them Friday. The other half I just got, so I haven't read them yet. So we will do the ones that I have read. And yeah, I'll say quick little stuff about it. Probably not much. If you hear background noise, it's my cat destroying things. So we got number 3, Avengers AI. This issue has now made me in love with this book. I love the concept. I don't know how many people are actually picking this up, but I hope more do. It's good. Like, it's very... I love Hank Pym, and I love Vision. And, I mean, this is about Hank Pym's, artificial intelligent Avengers. And, of course, it's Monday, so get over it. Spoiler alert. Vision's basically found out that he's, like, the Jesus, the god of this new AI world he's discovered. And basically, they're like us. They're lawyers, doctors, like fast food workers. And they're all very concerned that the human race can't accept them as a minority, so that we are going to go to war because we are scared, which is actually the truth. We're sitting outside their home and ready to bomb them. And they want Vision to step up, take leadership, and you know, that's kind of where this left off. If that sounds interesting to you, please pick this up, keep this going, because I really, really like this book. Then, the next one was issue number 3 of The Superior Foes of Spider-Man. I thought this was the best issue of this so far. I've really liked this book. I don't collect Deadpool. To me, this is like my Deadpool. This is a funny book. We did get to see a serious side of this, though, which I enjoyed. So it was a good contrast. This was a little more heftier reading than the other two. But I, like I said, it worked. I liked it. We got more of a backstory on you know, like the job that they've been planning and why this job is important. So it gives a lot of backstory and setup for what's to come. I really enjoyed this. Then a new series that started. Sorry, I'm trying to make sure my nose doesn't run on you. DC Universe versus Masters of the Universe, number 1. I liked it. It'll take me, it's a mini series. I'll need to read more. I've never read any Masters of the Universe. And as most know, I'm fairly new. You know, I'm probably only a couple months into DC. So it's getting to know, especially this one is very Masters of the Universe based, and I don't know a lot of the characters. I love Skeletor in it. It's not like, oh, like TV show silly Skeletor. Like, he's badass, like scary looking Skeletor. And I mean, you can basically guess what it is from the title. Like, these guys somehow are gonna meet, and they are gonna go to war, you know, the superheroes and supervillains, I would assume, as well, with Masters of the Universe. So I'm interested to see where it goes. Then probably the surprise, like this might even be one of my picks of the week, is issue number 1, The Mocking Dead. It's by Dynamite. If you can guess, yes, it is a comedy book making fun of The Walking Dead. I'll give you, like I said, it came out last week, so if you got it, you read it. I don't know how many people would actually have picked this up, but if you do see it, pick it up. It's hilarious. The whole concept is that, there's like a fat, unemployed comic book nerd, and he used to work for a government agency called Tinseltown, and spoiler alert, basically their job was to watch horror movies and create contingency plans for the US if any of those horror movies became true. And you know, they reference Twilight and you know, there's like some Green Lantern like porn in there. Literally like he's watching Green Lantern porn. It's just silly like that. And then of course it's kind of cool. It's in black and white with little hints of color, just kind of mocking The Walking Dead. It's a funny book, pick it up. I actually enjoyed it. I wasn't sure about it, but I enjoyed it. Next was The Superior Spider-Man number 17. This was I know a lot of people were waiting for this. Spider-Man 2099 versus Superior Spidey. Sorry. This book is this wasn't bad. This wasn't a bad issue. It's a setup. I mean, whoops, almost lost my books there. We're looking to get into this storyline, so it's a setup book. The last couple issues, I haven't been overly impressed. I haven't hated it enough to drop it, but it hasn't met up to the standards that the first run really gave us, and that worries me. Because I don't know if they're just running out of ideas or whatnot, but it just meh. And then of course the big Marvel book of the week, probably for anybody that's heavy Marvel. Sorry. Infinity Part 2 of 6. We continue on in this event. I really like the book. We're setting up for like some epic fighting. There already has been epic fighting. We're seeing how desperate everybody is, really. Thanos is kicking ass and taking names with his generals. Nothing's tougher than like one of the opening pages, just Wolverine just getting impaled by this big ass spear from one of the generals. I really like Black Bolt, and I'm probably gonna read some more up on him because he's a character that interests me now, and he intrigues me, so I will read about it. So I did like that, and then of course, you know, I'm a sucker for these. I had to get the Scotty Young variant. They had it there. I mean, who doesn't love baby Thanos? How can you not love him? He's so cute. Then next, man, this probably could contend for book of the week. This was one of my favorites. Jeff Lemire, number 2, Trillium. We finally, these two have met, and we have an issue that was needed. They're from different times. They're speaking different languages. So what can't they do the entire book that they're trying to do the entire book? Talk to one another, and it's very amusing because you're seeing her talking to him. And him not understanding what she's saying, and she's not understanding what he's saying, and you're seeing the back and forth of what it would be like to talk to someone that didn't know your language, and you're trying to get your point across. This really is like the highlight book out right now, I think, all over. It's not, it's in Vertigo. This is better, I think, than any DC or Marvel book right now. I love this book. I can't. If you are not getting this, please buy it. It is incredible. I know some people I've talked to kind of get turned off because, like, what is it? It's a love story, but it's probably one of the most unique love stories I've ever read, and I really enjoy it. Next up is number 4 of 5. Grimm Fairy Tales presents Hunters the Shadowlands. I was incorrect by saying that this was done last time. I thought this was like the werewolves one. It was only 3 issues. No, it is 5 issues. Love the cover. Obviously, Xenoscope, everyone knows, is basically like softcore porn. But the covers are really well done. The artwork's fantastic on the covers. The artwork's very different in the book. I like this. Like I said, Z, I'm not reading too much into it because I do plan on doing trades for Xenoscope. So this will be after issue number 5. The issue number 5 is the last Xenoscope I will be getting. in single issues. But it's still a good book. Then we have number 3, Dexter. I thought the release on this was kind of weird. Seeing how number 2, I believe, came out, well, I guess 2 weeks ago now. But it came out last time. And it took so long between 1 and 2. I mean, you know what they're doing. It's the last season of Dexter. So Marvel said, you know what? We're going to put out this mini and get our money's worth now. The build-up's been... It's only, I think, 5 issues. So we're getting there now at issue number 3. Still nothing crazy going on. We still don't know who's done it. It's all right. It's nothing exciting. I probably wouldn't recommend this to anyone if you're not picking it up already. Then another one of my favorites of the week is issue number 3 of 5, The Emerald City of Oz. I love this book. How can you not like that cover? It's a fun book. That's all it is. It's like a family-friendly book. It's fun. It's just fun. That's the only way to describe it. It killed me. There's a town called Utensila, and it's all utensils, and the names are hilarious. You know, there's like Miss Paprika, and spoiler, but I have to say, my favorite thing was their high priest is Cauldron, I think, or Mr. Cauldron. And Dorothy asks, why is your priest a cauldron? And he says, because he's the holiest person in the whole kingdom. And it's stuff like, you know, if you find little funny things like that funny, you'd like this book. It's fun, it's cute. There you go. Then, Villains Month. Let's get to it. Green Lantern Relic. The 3D cover. I don't know how well you can see this. This was good. I don't know anything about Relic. I just recently jumped on Green Lantern. I do know that he has extinguished the Blue Lanterns, I guess. I just like moving the cover, making Green Lantern move. Like he's booty shaking. But it was just a background, you know, all these are just, background stories for the villains, so it is what it is. I enjoyed it for what it was, and the short little read. And then the last one that I read was, of course, another title that I've, just jumped on a couple issues ago. Batman, of course, the Joker took over this one. If you can see it, the mouth moves. I see a lot of people hate on this book, and I honestly liked it. I took it for what it was. It wasn't going to be the world's greatest story. The art's amazing. I really enjoyed the art in it. I liked the cover. Obviously, I think people were kind of thrown because it wasn't so much a background on the Joker as it was the background on the relationship between Joker and his ape, Jack is something. I don't remember his name. But it was more about their relationship. I saw a lot of people complain about it. And you know, like, oh, it was about the ape, not the Joker, blah, blah. But, I mean, I guess that's kind of the fun in it, isn't the whole point of the Joker kind of be that he's the most mysterious kind of villain, you know, in terms of his background, no one really knows it. And I take it for what it is, they're just kind of little one-shots to give you these cool villain covers, so I love moving that mouth. So, yeah, I enjoyed it. Pick it up if you like the cover. I mean, that's what those books are all about. It's just if you like the cover. All right, and now these are the ones that I just picked up today. Obviously, all the 3D villain covers that I got on Friday were ones that I pull. Then I said, I saw some of the other ones, and I said, you know what? I think I'm going to get some. Because I like some of them. They're kind of cool. They're kind of background stories. The villains that kind of intrigue me that I want to learn about. And some of these series I might end up jumping on. So we'll see. So I got Batman, Dark Knight, 23.1. This is the Ventriloquist. I haven't read it, so I can't tell you how it is, but I do love the cover. Creeps me out. For some reason, this guy always reminds me of the Night of the Living Dummy from Goosebumps. That's how I explained it to my wife. Then I picked up Batman and Robin, Two-Face. I've always liked Two-Face, so I thought it was a cool issue to pick up. And then most people know, other than Superman Unchained, I pretty much am not a big Superman guy, as I also stated earlier in when I showed the picture. But I really like this cover, and why not find out about a villain I don't know anything about? So I got Action Comics 23.1, and it is Cyborg Superman. And I mean, how can you not like that, right? That's pretty badass cover. And then the last villain's cover that I got was Count Vertigo, Green Arrow. I love that cover. I can't really see. I think Green Arrow moves in the background. Green Arrow is a book that I've been interested in jumping on. So I'm going to read about one of his villains, see if this villain can entice me. And then I'll probably read a couple back issues. So from there, just two more pickups for new comics, and then three back issues, and we are done. I see this video is going. So we have Jonathan Hickman, God is Dead, number one. I am excited to read this. I've been waiting for this, as has my wife. I love Jonathan Hickman. He's one of my favorite writers. I know a lot of people complain that his stories take a long time to kind of... He puts a lot of stuff out there and then ties it all up, but it takes him a long time to kind of bring it to the point. I really like that style of writing, so he is one of my favorites. East of West of West is one of my favorite books. He's doing Infinity. I love Infinity. So I got this one, and then when I was at the shop, they also had a variant of it, so I got that. I think I like the first one better, the other one better, but we got this as well. And then I got, this was one that I had put on my pull list and they didn't pull for me. I take it they didn't get it, because my pull list store is not very good with independents. So my other store that is good at independents had it, so I figured I'd pick it up. It's the cover B for it, and it's just a one-shot, I believe. Yes. Love Stories to Die For, and it's kind of works like Trillium's first one did. It's a flip book, and it's just like Love Stories to Die For, I guess. I don't know. I thought it was a cool idea. The artwork looked cool, so I picked it up, give it a try. And then we'll do this quickly, back issues. I jumped on Red She-Hulk in number 65, not knowing that it was ending at like 68. So I think I was just looking in the dollar bin, and they had a couple back issues, so I said, why not? So I picked up Red She-Hulk number 58. Red She-Hulk number 59. And Red She-Hulk number 61. And after 23, almost 25 minutes, that is everything I got. I'm sick. I'm sweating. You guys want to stop listening and looking at, well, maybe not looking at me, but no, I'm just kidding. Anyway, you already know what it is. Turn up.